أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم Dear friends, welcome to Idea Foundation Forum. In the last session, we discussed part one of man's place in the universe. Is the humanly universe bigger than the heavenly universe? This is the question. Today, in its part two, we will discuss some other important areas related to this subject. These programs are presented under the title Allah, Quran and Insan. Interested friends can visit ideafoundation.com.pk website or its YouTube channel to watch previous videos or read the papers on the website. In the last session, we concluded that the man is standing at the central point from where a limitless universe is outward, heavenly universe, and a matching universe is inward, which is humanly universe. In its continuity today, we will discuss some important aspects of the two universes and unfolding nature of the Quranic knowledge with the growth of intellect and knowledge of the universe. These aspects are comparison of the heavenly universe and humanly universe. Number two, purpose of this comparison. Next is unknown domains of both the universes lead to infinity. Purpose of discussion of the humanly universe as an independent unit was to highlight the overwhelmingly unique status of the man in the universe. Otherwise, surely the man is integral part of the heavenly universe. Understanding of human intellectual growth and physical growth of the universe. Common features of the two universes. Infinity, common integrative spirit, extra, extra. Unfolding nature of the universe with the intellectual growth. Next is unfolding nature of the Quran with the intellectual growth. Laws of nature never change. It is what the destiny is. The Quran never changes because it reveals the laws of nature. However, understanding of the Quran is of unfolding nature. Like the universe, its understanding expands with the intellectual growth. Like the universe, the Quran's knowledge known to the man keeps on increasing. Yet, much is left to be known with the time to come, with the growth of intellect. Dear friends, let us have a comparison of the heavenly universe and humanly universe. The first is knowledge about the universe. Knowledge about the universe in both the cases is limited to the observable extent. Number two is size of the universe. Size of the heavenly universe is infinite outwardly. It is always growing, expanding. Whereas size of the humanly universe is also infinite but inwardly. The divisibility of atom, then protons, man doesn't know what is the limit. Then its nature of the universe. Both the universes are expanding and dynamic. For example, humanly universe, 13.8 billion years ago, light of the galaxies located right on the edge of the observable universe took 13 billion years to reach to us, which now must take 46.5 billion light years to reach to us, which means the heavenly universe has expanded more than 3 times since its birth. Likewise, humanly universe is also expanding. You know the growth rate, you are aware of it. Now at the moment, mankind's population has grown to 8 billion. Likewise, in a young, healthy man, 98% atoms are replaced each year. Now coming to the number of universes, heavenly universe is one. Cosmic universe is one. Whereas humanly universes are 8 billion because we have taken one man as a universe. Now coming to galaxies and human cells, heavenly universe is comprising of 200 billion to 2 trillion galaxies. The minimum estimate is 200 billion or 100 billion, and the maximum estimate is 2 trillion galaxies. Whereas human cells, a body has 40 trillion human cells. Just imagine. What is the size of galaxy and what is the size of human cell? A galaxy contains billions of stars of the sun's size, whereas a human cell contains about approximately 100 trillion atoms in it. Now, how many stars and how many atoms are in the universe? In the whole heavenly universe, there are trillions of stars, whereas in a human body, there are 7 octillion atoms. You know what is octillion? Just have a look on the screen. If you write 7, then write 27 zeros. It is called octillion. It is millions, then 1,000 times a trillion. Now, what is the functional features of the two universes? Both are integrative and centric. There is some divine system which is integrating both the universes. The last but not the least, what is the driving force behind these two universes? Both the universes are driven through divine force of Allah. The discussed comparison of the heavenly universe and the humanly universe concludes that in terms of numerical strength, arithmetic strength of its constituent members, each human being is a much bigger universe than the heavenly universe. It means the mankind is accorded with about 8 billion human universes. Another amazing feature of the humanly universe is that every atom contains the same DNA that provides a unique identity to the concerned man. And also, every atom contains a nucleus which determines the existence of the respective cell. Single common DNA pervasive in trillions of cells in a human body symbolizes centrality of command and identity of a human. Now just imagine the grand order maintained by Allah, where for one man trillions of cells and atoms are replaced or replicated every year, ensuring the sanctity of his DNA intact. Another mystery about DNA revealed by the Quran has now been witnessed by science. If 5 pieces of a man's body are tested at different continents of the earth. The same DNA will be reported from all the five distant places. It reminds the Quranic references with respect to Day of Resurrection, when a man will be called by his identity and all his limbs will respond in unison. Surah Maryam explains this fact in the words, لَقَدْ أَحْصَاهُمْ وَعَدَّهُمْ عَدَّا. Its translation is, He has enumerated them. He means Allah. Them means mankind. He has enumerated them and counted them a full counting. Likewise, Surah Kaf reveals this truth. قَدْ عَلِمْنَا مَا تَنْقُصُ الْأَرْضُ مِنْهُمْ وَإِنْدَنَا كِتَابٌ حَفِيظٌ. Its translation is, We know what the earth diminishes of them, and with us is a retaining record. As we have been discussing in previous session regarding the grand plan organized by Allah for the mankind, the man was accorded a status envious to the angels and the jinns, blessed with a unique personality of Ahsani Taqweem and knowledge that made him superior among the creatures. To save him falling into the abyss of Asfala Safilin, he was blessed with the divine soul and the divine guidance as well. Now look at the task the man was assigned in the capacity of vicegerent, as stated in Ayat 65 of Surah Al-An'am. The Quran says, It is he who hath made you his agent, inheritors of the earth. He hath raised you in ranks, some above others, that he may try you in the gifts. He hath given you, for the Lord is quick in punishment, yet he is indeed often forgiving, most merciful. Ayat 20 of Surah Luqman reveals the powers and command accorded to the man over the universe and the abilities apparent and unapparent bestowed to him so that he could perform his role of vicegerent well. The Quran says, Do you not see that Allah has made subject to you whatever is in the heavens? What is heavens? Universe. And whatever is in the earth, and amply, adequately bestowed upon you his favors, both apparent and unapparent. But of the people is he who disputes about Allah without knowledge or guidance or an enlightening book from Allah. The said Quranic references explain the reasons why the man was given such extraordinary physical systems. It was to perform extraordinary task of managing the universe as the vicegerent of Allah in the light of the divine guidance. Please ponder on the role that has been assigned to the man. Our religion gives us great vistas of life. To Iqbal, real pursuits of a Muslim lie beyond the stars. He says, there are worlds beyond the stars which await the attention of the man. For friends who know Urdu language, सितारों से आगे जहां और भी हैं, अभी इश्क के इम्तहान और भी हैं. Interpreting the Quran, Iqbal advises the man to open up his intellect to access the treasures of knowledge and wisdom lying in the nature. In Urdu he says, tu hi chand kaliyon par kinat kar gaya, varna gulshan mein ilaaje tangiye dama bhi hai. Allah has called wisdom or intellect a great blessing or reward. In Surah Bakra, Allah says, yu'til hikmata man yasha'u wa man yu'tal hikmata faqad utiya khayran kaseera wa ma yazakkaru illa ulul albab. Its translation is, he gives wisdom to whom he wills, and whoever has been given wisdom has certainly been given much good, and none will remember except those of understanding. Thus the man is desired to keep expanding his intellect to best perform the task he is blessed with, because he will be strictly accounted for his performance of this task, which will ultimately determine his final status in the hereafter. Therefore, the purpose of the comparison of the heavenly and humanly universes was to understand the man's privileged status in the heavenly universe, nature of his task, and competence for managing the affairs of the earth and the universe. Performance of his operational life of this earth will determine his status in the hereafter. Both the universes, heavenly and humanly, have their movement to infinity, limitlessness. We know the immensity of the observable heavenly universe, but besides the scientific excellence, we cannot even guess the contours of the unknown heavenly universe, except believing it to be infinity in outward movement, as it is ever growing in size. As the Quran says, He, means Allah, adds to its creation, to its glory, every day. Likewise, the man's cell is divided into atoms in trillions, which is further and further subdivided, leading to infinity. Science has discovered the divisibility of atom just recently, a fact that the Quran had told much earlier. Ayat 61 of Surah Yunus says, and not absent from your Lord is any part of an atom's weight within the earth or within the heaven, or anything smaller than that or greater, but that it is in a clear register. Thus, the unknown domains of both the universes lead to infinity. The purpose of discussion of the humanly universe as an independent unit was to highlight the overwhelmingly unique status of the man in the universe. Otherwise, surely, the man is an integral part of the heavenly universe. The man's being has a unique DNA, pervasive in every part of his body, a nucleus, the pivot of life, and an integrative commanding force that is spiriting the man to act according to the laws of nature. Ayat 9 of Surah As-Sajdah says, then he fashioned him, man. Then Allah fashioned man in due proportion and breathed into him the soul, and he gave you hearing, means ears, sight, eyes, and hearts. Hearts are the mansion of the soul. Little is the thanks you give. And what is this integrative commanding force that is spiriting the man to act according to the laws of nature? Ayat 85 of Surah Al-Isra says, وَيَسْأَلُونَكَ عَنِ الرُّوحِ قُلِ الرُّوحُ مِنْ أَمْرِ رَبِّي وَمَا أُوتِيتُم مِّنَ الْعِلْمِ إِلَّا قَلِيلًا. Its translation is, and they ask you, O Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, about the soul. Say, the soul is of the affairs of my Lord, and mankind has not been given of knowledge except a little. Though the man is an integrative universe in itself, yet it is an integral part of the heavenly universe. Like the humanly universe, the heavenly universe also has a unified singular system, a nucleus, and all-pervasive spirit commanding its existence and affairs. Ayat 35 of Surah An-Nur says, Allahu Nuru Samawati wal Arz. Allah is the light of the heavens and the earth. The man will keep on knowing such secrets of the nature with the advancement of his intellect, as Allah has promised in Ayat 53 of Surah Fussilat. Sanurihim ayatina fil afaqi wa fi anfusihim hatta yatabayyana lahum annahu al-haq. Its translation is, we will show them our signs. Allah says, we will show them our signs in the horizons, universe, and within themselves, until it becomes clear to them that it is the truth. Therefore, it is obligatory for us to expand our intellect to know the laws of nature better, for clear understanding of the oneness of Allah, His all-pervasive sovereignty over the affairs of the universe and the man, and manage the affairs of the society to establish justice, peace, progress, and collective well-being of the mankind, accomplishing the purpose of the man's creation. We conclude our discussion here today. In the next session, we will discuss relationship of intellectual growth, expansion of universe, and unfolding nature of the Quran. Dear friends, these programs are recorded both in Urdu and English. Their videos can be watched on ideafoundation.com.pk website, or its YouTube channel and Facebook. Their written versions are also available on the Idea Foundation's website. Please note code number of this program, Idea 1AR4 Part 2. All friends are requested to subscribe the Foundation's YouTube web channel for the benefit of this noble cause. Thank you, friends. Allah Hafiz.